Hi, I'm Vikram and welcome back to Role of Film. In today's video, I'm going to take a look at a medium format TTL camera, the Yashica Mat 124G. The Yashica Mat 124G was produced from 1970 to 1986 by the Yashica Company, Japan. The 124G is the last in a long line of TLR cameras brought out by the Yashica company, and it is considered the best and the most advanced model. Now, a twin lens reflex camera has two lenses, one on top of each other. One lens is known as the viewing lens and the bottom one is known as the taking lens. So as the name suggests, you look through the top lens and you actually take the photograph from the bottom lens. The Yashica Mat 124G is a medium format camera that takes both 120 and 220 film. It gives you a 6x6 negative, which means that you can have 12 exposures in a 120 and 24 exposures in a 220 roll of film. It has a built-in meter, which is operated by a battery, and it has an 80mm, a 4-element 80mm Yashinon 3.5 lens, considered by many to be one of the best Yashinon lenses ever made. It also has a Kopal SV leaf shutter. Right, so let's just have a closer look at the camera. So right on top, you have the light meter. And by the way, the contacts of this light meter are gold plated. So that's why you have the G, the 124G. That's how it differs from the 124 basically, in the sense that the contacts are gold plated. Like I said before, it has the 80mm lens. Now, an 80mm lens is usually the standard lens that you got on these TLR cameras, which is approximately corresponds to about a 50mm lens on a 35mm roll. So you have here these two knobs. Both, one is to control the shutter speed and the other is to control your aperture. And the aperture starts, as I said, 3.5, goes all the way up to 32. Shutter speeds, you have the bulb mode and goes all the way up to 500. So 500th of a second is your fastest shutter speed. The shutter button is here in the right hand corner, and it has a shutter lock. It is also compatible with the shutter release cable, which is rather helpful, and it also has a self timer here. 124G has a waist level viewfinder which pops up like this. You look down, you hold the camera at waist level, look down, achieve focus and take the shot. It has a ground glass there which helps you achieve your focus. It's also extremely bright because the viewing lens is a 2.8 lens. It also has magnifying glass that pops out like this. This helps you achieve critical focus. It also has what is known as sports finder. You put this down and you can shoot through this. This is like a normal viewfinder, but I much prefer to use the waist level viewfinder, because after all that is something very characteristic of these twin lens reflex cameras, and you can really, I think probably one of the coolest things in this camera. So now let's just have a look at both of the sides, the left and the right hand side. So on the left hand side, you have your this dial, which is basically a focusing dial, and the minimum focus distance is 1 meter or 3.3 feet. Out here, it has the small disc that moves around with a small window so that you know what film you have loaded on. You have MT, then you have black and white, daylight negative, daylight reversal, tungsten reverse, and empty. So pretty useful. Also out here on the left hand side, you have this thing, space here for your battery, which powers the light meter. Yes, the light meter is powered by a battery. Unfortunately, you don't get these batteries anymore. But I believe you can get a replacement battery, but I don't bother because I generally don't use the meter. It also has here a knob here. It's a little stiff in this, which allows you to choose the ASA. Unfortunately, the highest ASA you can go to here for your meter is 400. So anything above 400, you just have to manage. Maybe use an external light meter, use a smartphone app, or use the Sunny 16 rule. And on top, you have the needle and ball kind of thing, which when they align, when you move your this thing, will give you your proper meter reading. And like I said, I don't use it, so not much there. Also here you have a cold shoe flash, so where you can attach your flash, and you have your sync cable here, flash sync cable here. Now on the right hand side you have your FIM advanced lever. This is a handheld crank. Sounds great, really fun to use. You also have two windows here. One that tells you whether you're using a 120 film or a 220 film. It just tells you the number of frames. So like I said before, 12 frames for 120, 24 frames for 220. So this gives you an indication as to which film you're using. And also here you have your frame counter here, which will tell you which frame you're on. The Yashica TLR cameras were an economical alternative to the Rolleiflex cameras. They were much cheaper, probably 1/4 the cost, and they gave you about 85% of the Rolleiflex. Now what started off as a copy basically of the Rolleiflex went on to become a classic in its own right. This camera is a gem of a camera. I have shot a lot of rolls with this camera and I have reviewed those rolls. So if any of you are interested, I'll drop a couple of links down in the description. Please do have a look. The Yashica is by far my favorite medium format camera. It was actually my first medium format camera, and I really, really love shooting with this. It really, for those who are interested, you can really, using these TLRs are actually, according to me, even though it's not that old a camera, it really gives you the feel of analog film photography. There's something about this clunky little brick. I wouldn't like to call it a brick, but for the lack of a better word, something in this camera that really, really makes it a pleasure to use. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you have, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel.